Hello everyone, today I am going to show you a very interesting effect in Blackmagic Design Fusion, and that effect is called sometime ghost effect or trail effect or ghost trail effect. Okay, so let's start. So here I have this fusion interface and I want to import one alembic file in my project. So for that, to import alembic file, I just go to file, import alembic scene. Okay, and here I have one alembic file dance.abc, and just I open this file. Okay, and I just drag this transform 3D one to my viewport, and here you see I got one alembic file. I just create that alembic file in Maya. So when I play this thing, so if you don't know how to export alembic file through Maya, I'll show you. So I just open Maya. So here I have one Maya file, and this is my rigged character. And whenever you have some rigged character or some deformation in your animation and you want to import that thing in any compositing software that support 3D content, then alembic file is the best option for that. And now how to export this thing into alembic file through Maya. So I just select this content. I just need to select this body or say geometry. Okay, and then go to cache. If this thing is not available in Maya, then you have to go to Windows setting, plugin manager, and you need to select this ABC export and obviously ABC import. Well, but right now we need to export, so you should select these things. I just select this, I go to cache, alembic, and export selection to alembic. And whatever you want to export, for example time slider, that is 1 to 265, if you want to set a particular range, you just select these things and define that range that you want to export. And if this character has some UV unwrapping, and after that in post-production you want to apply some texture on that, then you must select this UV right option in advanced option. Okay, and then export selection, and whenever you want to export the thing, for example here, dance and export selection. Okay, so this is how you can export your file in alembic. If I already told that if you have some deformation contained in your animation, then alembic file is very helpful. And if there is some animation only in transform, for example rotation, scale and position, then FBX is best option. And if you have no animation in your scene and you just want to import only that contain, then OBG is also preferable, but OBG don't support camera and all the stuff, so alembic and FBX is preferable for my point of view. Okay, so again I move to Fusion. Okay, so here I have this animation and I want to create the ghost trail 3D effect in Fusion. Okay, so this is very simple step to create this thing. You just need to create one more node, and that is your duplicate 3D node. Okay, so what duplicate 3D did, for example, I create 3 copy of that and I change offset, so it's just generate 3 duplication of this particular input. So here the main factor is this time offset. You can change time offset of these things. For example, I just put 3 frames, then see the variation. If I put 10, so what I have to do, first of all I reset this transform offset. Okay, and here in time offset I need to set this time offset to -1. Now you see some trail thing created, but what I have to do, I need the duplication for each and every frame. So what I have to do, so here in this last copy option I just right click over here, I set expression, and here I set expression time +1. So if I put only time, then on first frame I don't get any character, so for that I just add +1. Okay, and now you see the magic of this effect. Okay, now the another thing, so this is very simple thing that you just need to put this expression and your time offset should be -1, that's it, and you get some good ghost trail effect in 3D. Okay, now in my example, the first character in different color of, that is the main contain, and another trail effect in some other color or some gradient or whatever. So what I have to do, so for that I need one replace material 3D. Okay, and here I put this, I create one branch from here. Okay, and I put another material, or I just change the color from here, for example orange color. Now I create one merge 3D node and I merge this and this. Okay, but sometimes see, because the thickness of my this character and these duplications are same, so what I have to do to show this character properly, so for that I create one displays 3D over here. So if I want to put this displacement in between this, I just need to click shift and I put over here, and I create one BG with white color. Okay, and I put this white background as my displacement map on this displace 3D node. So now you see the character look like this. So I should reduce the scale of this character. So for example 0.1, and I just set over here. And I gradually change the value. For example, 0.05, is it okay? Yeah. Or maybe 0.02, 0.01, 0.001. Okay. That's great. So now you see if you feel over here like you lost the character detail, so I just come over here and increase the scale of displacement. That's it. And through that you should define the source contain and that trail thing. Okay, so things is very simple. You just need to use some great tool of this Blackmagic Design Fusion. And this will help you in some motion graphics things and all those stuff. Okay. So with this same concept, I can create branches effect in Fusion. Okay, so the concept is same. The duplication of ghost duplication. Okay, but how I create, and you can see this example on screen, how I create these branches. So let's see how I create those branches. So I create one more composition. Now to create these branches, I'm going to use particle system. Okay, so you can learn some more particle concept of Fusion maybe through this example, and how to implement your particle system in motion graphics is very important thing of this example. So for that, I create one particle emitter and particle renderer. Okay, and I just set my timeline to 200 frames. I drag things over here. And here you see some particle over here. So what I have to do, I just put my numbers of particle to 1. I right click over here, animate, just go to next frame and I set it to 0. As well as in lifespan, I set it to maybe 160. Okay, so now if I see, my particle is over here. So I need to give some velocity to my particle, but before that I need to change the style of this particle. So I just go to style, and style I just change it to line, and maybe in size I just change it to 1.2 or 1.3, whatever, like this. Okay, now again go to controllers, I go to velocity, I give some velocity, for example 0.07, and velocity variance 0.01. this is not necessary. If I have some more particles, then this velocity variance work very finely. And obviously the roots go on up directions, so I need to change the angle to 90 degree. Okay, so right now it's move like this. So I go to rotation and change always face camera, because whenever I move this camera, it always this particle face to the camera. So I just off these things, and in rotation mode I change it to rotation relative to motion, so it rotate according to its motion. So right now it just go upwards. Okay, now the branches should be move little randomly, so for that I just add one turbulence. In turbulence I change the value maybe 0.2. for Y I set it to 0, and in Z 0.2, and in density maybe I increase some density like this. So now I'm going to check, it's move like this. Okay, great. Okay, and I also add some friction. And the value of friction is very high, so I just reduce the thing 0.07, 0.007. So it moves like this. Okay, so this is my base of the branch. Okay, so through that I can create branch. And how? So for that I need one shape 3D. Okay, and I use con to create the branches. Okay, so top radius maybe 0.2, top radius maybe 0.19, and height little less, 0.3 maybe. Okay, and I should set bottom and top cap like this. Okay, now I select this P renderer, I go to tools, 3D, and replicate 3D, and I just set over here. And here in replicate 3D you should align your contain in TBN. TBN means tangent, binormal and normal. So its contain moves or rotate along your replicate source. So I should change the rotation of this, for example here in Z minus 90 degree, so it's behave properly. And now you see it goes like that. Okay, now on this replicate 3D, if I create the same concept, that duplicate 3D, that ghost trail effect concept. So here in time offset -1, and in last copy right click, add expression, and expression is time plus 1. And now you see the magic. I want to narrow this branch on the top. Okay, so for that I have to go to emitter in style. This is the size over life. So I just drag these things over here. And now if I check, and you see, and if I change the color of this material, like some okay, now the main thing is I need more sub branches from this tree. So what should I do? So for that I need to work on this particle system. So this is my base particle. Now I need to create or need to generate particles out of this particle system. So for that, okay, so for that I create P spawn. So what P spawn do? So P spawn create a particle from this particle system. Okay, so I need to and if I check these things, and you see now we have some more particle over here. So I need to change something, like in velocity control, the velocity transform. So this is one. So what basically it did, it transformed the parent velocity to its child velocity. So right now I set it to 0. Now you see, okay, but I don't want that much particle for branches. Okay, so I reduce the number to 0.1, and life span is okay 100 frame, and plus and minus 10. And again in style I need to change it to line, and for size things maybe 0.6, okay, and in controllers same with rotation, always face camera off and rotation relative to motion. And now I check this thing. Okay, so in replicate 3D now you can see and in duplicate 3D we can see like that. But as you see here the size of branch is okay, but we need little thinner size of this sub branch over here. So what I have to do, and obviously I need some taper on these branches. So For tapering, I have to go to style on this piece pawn, and same thing we need to do over here. And here, what I have to do, I just select animate, and here I have 160 lifespan, so I just go to 160. And here I set it to 0.001 maybe. So now if I play this thing, it look like this. Okay, even you can animate the life span also. For example, over here animate, and here maybe 20. Now if I play this thing, but now the thing is that I need more turbulence on these branches. So what I should do, and I don't want any particle generate over here, and even not over here. So what I have to do, just I select piece one, I go to condition, and I reduce these things over here. So this is the edge of my parent particle. So when it should create the sub particle is when between the edge of 0.1 to 0.84. So now I play this stuff. You see, over here it did not create any branch. And now the secondary thing is that I want more turbulence on this p-spawn particle only, not in this main particle, because that is very fine for me. So what I have to do to apply particular effect or particular force on particular particle system. So for that, I just select this p-spawn, I go to sets, and I select this set to, for example, set 1. Okay, so now I define this piece 1 as set 1, or I can set it, put it at set 2 if I want to do some more thing or more controller over here. So I have to put that main particle into set 1, but right now I don't want this thing, so I just put my piece 1 in set 2. Okay, now I add P turbulence, and here in condition the thing is set mode, define effect specific set, and I deactivate this set 1, set 3 and set 4. Because this is not available sets, and I have only one set available, that is set 2. So now this turbulence affect only on set 2, and I just change some controllers. For example, here I put 0.18, maybe 0.15, 0.13, like this. Now if I change the thing, okay, I should change some more thing in p-span style 0.9. now if I play this thing, And you see, now if I need more branches, I just need to change the numbers, for example 2. And you see, so with this concept you can create more innovative things with using the default tools of Blackmagic Design Fusion. Hope you like this tutorial. See you soon with another tutorial.